Hi guys, welcome to this session on DI, data interpretation. So this is a typical, this entire set is a typical caselet type of a DI. Caselet, by caselet I mean that it talks about the information in a paragraph manner, or let's say in a case wise. So in this type of a DI, you won't be given the tables. So you would be given a paragraph containing all the details, and you need to prepare a table or a chart which contains all the details, as so that you can answer your questions. So in this type of a question, no paragraph, no graph or no bar chart or pie chart, nothing is there. So it just talks about the data in a compact manner, where we have to understand the data and comprehend it, and then you can make a table and make a chart as per your understanding. Okay, so we'll just go with the question. And this caselet, this DI is from one of the mocks which is given by Olive Board. So I'll discuss this DI set. This is one of the mocks, I have appeared this mock from Olive Board, and I found this question to be really interesting. This is one such, those kind of a question which normal people leave the DI set, but you can gain plus five marks here in just about, 6 to 7 minutes. So it's just involves some kind of calculation, and everything is pretty simple over there. Okay, we'll just go with the question. Okay, what is the question saying? The following information is about the total number of savings and current account in six different branches, SBI, PNB, ICICI, HDFC, BOB and Allahabad. And the total savings plus current in all the banks is 27,000, and the ratio is 5:4. Great. So which means that if the total is 27,000, see, for understanding, I've just made the tables out here. With bank's current account, savings account, and the total is 27,000. So the total is 27,000 in the ratio. The CASA ratio is nothing but 4:5. See, here it is given 5:4, but what is that? Savings is to current, right? So I've taken CASA, which is current is to savings, which is nothing but 4:5. Now, four parts will correspond to what? 12,000. And five parts will correspond to what? 15,000, so that the sum is 27,000. I hope this is clear. No need to explain this. Great. Next, moving on to the next set. I'll just simply write this down, because it will help me to understand and again make the calculations easy. So the total is 77,000. Now, the savings account in Allahabad is 40% of that in PNB. Okay. So I'll just write the banks. It is SBI. It is PNB, ICICI, HDFC, BOB, and Allahabad Bank. Check it. Okay. So the savings account in Allahabad. Savings account in Allahabad is 40%, that is PNB. So let me take the PNB X. So this would be nothing but 0.4X. Clear? I don't know the figure, but I'll keep it in terms of X. Next, 24% of the total savings account are in HDFC. Total savings account. So what is the total savings account with us? Is 15,000. So 24% of 15,000 is 24% of 15,000 is with whom? Is with HDFC. So what is 24% of 15,000? It is 3,600. So I'll write 3,600 over here. So I'm just trying to fill the data, fill the table. Okay. Next, 15% of the total savings account are in PNB. So 15% of total savings account, which is 15,000, is with PNB. So PNB, so 15% of 15,000 is nothing but 2,250. So we are getting the savings account for PNB, which is 2,250. So if this was X and this is 0.4X, so 0.4 of 2,250 is what? 0.4 of 2,250. I hope this is understood, right? So this is nothing but 2/5 of 2,250. This is nothing but 2/5 of 2,250. Right? Which is what? Which is 900. So I've got 900. Next is current account. 25% of the total current account is with ICICI. Total current account is what? 12,000. So 25% is nothing but 1/4. So this becomes 3000. Correct. Next, ratio of current account in ICICI Bank to that of SBI is 5:7. So ratio of current account in ICICI Bank to savings to SBI is nothing but 5:7. This part is clear, the data. Now ICICI Bank mein current account kitna hai? 3000 hai. So SBI mein kitna hoga? 4200, isn't it? SBI mein current account 4200 ho jayega. Next, current account in PNB is 80% of that in savings account of PNB only. So current account in PNB is nothing but 80% of savings account. So 80% of 2250 kya hota hai? 80% is nothing but 4/5 of 2250 is what? Is nothing but 1800. Understood? Now from here, can I say the total savings plus current of PNB is nothing but 4050? See, first we have to jot down the data and then we have to make all the totals, right? So that it becomes easier for us to understand and comprehend the data. Okay. Next, the ratio of current account to savings account in Allahabad is 2:3. So current account to savings account is 2:3. So which means that 3 corresponds to 900, then 2 will correspond to what? Obviously, 600. When I like the 600. Next. So we are done with this. Next, the ratio of current account to savings account in HDFC is 2:5. HDFC is 2:5. Now, if this is 2:5 and 5 corresponds to 3600, then 2 will correspond to what? 2 will correspond to 1440, because 5 into 720 is 3600. Then 2 into 720 would be 1400. So HDFC mein kya ho jaya rahi hai? 1440. So I have all the figures filled up for HDFC. So ye total kitna ho jayega? This would be nothing but 5040. Now I have all these 5 banks. Now the 6th bank would be nothing but 12,000 minus the summation of all these things, which is what? 960. Right? So this is how you need to fill up the table. Next, total accounts, which is savings plus current in SBI, is 30% of the total accounts in all the 6 banks. So SBI is having 30% of the total accounts in all the 3 banks. So total accounts kitna hai? 27,000. So uska 30% kya ho jayega? Uska 30% kya ho jayega? Is nothing but 3/10 of 27,000, which is nothing but 8,100. So the total accounts in SBI is 8,100. If 8,100 mil gaya mere ko, aur mere ko yahan par 4,200 mil gaya, 4,200 mil gaya, to yahan par 8,100 se 4,200 minus kar dunga, to kitna mil jayega mera? 3,900. Kitna mil jayega mera? 3900. तो अगर यहाँ पर मेरे को 3900 मिल गया, तो नेक्स्ट डेटा मेरे को ढूंढना है। तो नेक्स्ट डेटा क्या बोल रहे हैं? VOB में 15% किसका है? टोटल का। टोटल मतलब क्या है? 27,000. तो 27,000 का 1500 कितना होता है? 27,000 का 1500 के 15% कितना होता है? I'll get it as 15% is nothing but 3/20 of 27,000. So this is nothing but 1350. So this will be what? 4050. So BOB mein 4050 likh diya. Understood? Clear hai na? Check it. Next. The number of savings account in HDFC is what percent? Okay, so we are straight away with the questions. So there is no other data. So these are the 5 questions available. So there is no other data. Now from here, we need to sort the entire data. we need to fill the tables, which means that I need to fill all those missing places. Now 600 plus 900 is what? 1500. Okay. Now we have 1500, 4500, 5040, 4050 out here, and 8100. So I can subtract all the summation of this from 27,000 to get this value. ICICI ka total kitna mil jayega mere ko agar subtract karta hu to, 4060. Now if I get 4060 and I know 3000, so and I put this as 1060, sorry, this would be one, just a minute, I'll meet this as 4260 and this will be 1260. Just check with the addition part. Okay. Next, if I get all these figures, I can get this figure as well by subtracting from 15,000, which is nothing but 3090. Okay. So now when we are done with the table, I'll just show you the entire thing in just a minute. So now when we are done with the entire table, we can answer any questions correctly. Okay. So I'll show you what is the actual data. So after we have got everything, the entire data will show something like this. Okay. So we have the savings account over here. We have the current account. In our case, we did the current account and savings account first, and then we did the savings account second. So in our data, we have done current account first and then savings account. So the solution they have given is savings account current account, which doesn't matter. Either of them is correct. Okay. So now we are done with this. Now we will solve the questions. Now what is the question? First question, number of savings account in HDFC bank is what percent of the total current account in PNB? So number of savings account in HDFC. Savings account in HDFC matlab kya hai? 3600. Of what? The total number of current account in PNB. Current account in PNB matlab kitna hua? 1800. So what is the percentage? This is nothing but 200%. So the answer for this is 200%. Very simple. What is the total number of accounts, savings plus current in ICICI Bank? ICICI Bank total kya kitna ho rahega? 4260. Pretty evident. So once you figure out the table, or once you fill up the table, all the data, all the questions can be solved easily, right? Next, and this can be done actually in very if you are very fast with the calculations, you can finish this in about 4 to 5 minutes only. Instead of taking 6-7 minutes, you can finish it about 4 to 5 minutes. So ideal time, if you are very good with the calculations, 4 to 5 minutes plus 5 marks. This question has to be done. This should not be skipped. Okay. Next, find the total number of savings account in Allahabad Bank. Okay. So the total number of savings account in Allahabad Bank, which is 900. Okay. Is what less, or is how much less than the total number of current account BBOB? Current account BBOB kitna hai? 960. So kitna less hai? 60. Great. So the first three questions are very, very easy. Next, total number of current account in SBI. Current account in SBI kitna hai? 4200. Is approximately what percent of the total number of accounts in all the 6 banks? Total number of accounts to mere ko pata hai ye pehle se. 27,000. So 27,000 ka kitna portion? 4200. It is nothing but, let's calculate. So this would be 42 by 270, which is nothing but 21 by 135, which is nothing but 7 by, this would be 45, right? Into 100 ho jayega. So this is nothing but 20 by 9. So this is nothing but 140 by 9%. So 140 by 9, you can write it as 15.5% approximately. Okay. Approximately 15.5%. I hope it is correct. One time that is 50, which is 545. And then, yeah. So 15.5%. Next, the total number of current account in SBI. This is done. Okay. So I'll write this as 15.5%. Great. The total number of current account in BOB. So I need to find the ratio. Total number of current account in BOB is what? 960. Two, the total number of savings account in ICICI. Savings account in ICICI is what? 1260. Find the ratio. So this is what? This is 48 and this is 63. So this is 16. This is 21. So it is 16:21. So the answer is 16:21. So did you understand how the case study diary works? So it comes with a paragraph and you have to figure it out and form a table or a tabular or a data chart. Okay. This is how you answer a case study type of data. So mostly in recent times, the case study AI is coming in SBI PO or IBPS type of questions, preliminary as well as in mains as well. So these, if this kind of set comes, which is very easy or looks compact and the data is less and this type of percentage and ratio are there. So do not hesitate, plunge into that question and we can definitely solve these questions, right? So I hope there is no problem with this. If there is any, just let me know. I'll definitely solve your query. Thank you guys. Happy learning.